In the following episode, I'll talk about materials enabling VAT photopolymerization. Very important, and the secret to that whole process is really the material. The material of choice for VAT photopolymerization are photopolymers. And photopolymers are thermosets that are highly cross-linked on network polymers, so giant macromolecules that have covalent bonds instead of the entanglements that we know from other polymers, such as thermoplastics, or they have hydrogen van der Waals bonds between the chains. But for thermosets and photopolymers who are part of that group, we have the strong covalent bonds. The liquid components are mixed, and the solid state is reached through curing, also called cross-linking. That process is non-reversible. You can't uncross-link a material. Because of those covalent bonds, the network, we have high rigidity, and thermosets are more brittle than thermoplastics. But the cross-linking results in a higher glass transition temperature, which means a higher thermal stability, and they're generally very resistant to solvents. When we now look at light curing in particular, which is a subgroup of thermosets, we normally start with premixed liquids. They already come in the bottles, and the bottles are kept in black or brown bottles inside of a closed shelf that we don't risk any exposure to light beforehand. But we have the premixed liquid, so you don't have to play with that, with ratios, and make sure that you mix it in the right time before it starts curing. And the curing is initiated by a specific wavelength. Typically, that's UV light. The reactive groups that we need to build the covalent bonds are created by light exposure. And examples of photopolymers that are used in additive manufacturing, we have acrylate, epoxies, and now also polyurethane, cyanide ester. There's more and more development going on in that area.